Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be going through the theory behind the Gauss-Seidel Method. Alright, so what is the Gauss-Seidel Method? The Gauss-Seidel Method is an iterative numerical method that can aid us in solving for linear systems of equations. If you've seen our previous videos on Jacobi Method, also known as Jacobi Iteration, then learning the Gauss-Seidel Method will be very easy for you. In short, the Gauss-Seidel Method is the exact same thing as the Jacobi iteration, except instead of solving for all of your x values and then taking an iterative step, you use the newly found x values for your next step. Let's walk through the steps of solving a problem with the Gauss-Seidel method, and it should make sense. Firstly, just note that this method works for linear systems of equations, and we are guaranteed convergence if our matrix is diagonally dominant, just like Jacobi iteration. So, the steps to solving a system of linear equations using the Gauss-Seidel method are the following. Step 1. Make a guess for every x value in your x matrix. Therefore, we need to assume a value for x1, x2, x3, etc. for as many x values as you have. Let's call our initial iteration 0, as many programming languages, like Python, have 0 indexing, meaning we begin counting from 0. However, if you are using MATLAB, begin at 1, as it does not use zero indexing. A typical starting guess is just a zero matrix unless we have some additional information about the problem that could help our guess. The benefit of having a better starting guess is that we achieve our final solution in less iterations, and therefore less time. However, as I mentioned earlier, if the matrix is diagonally dominant, then you can literally put any guess here and it will eventually converge. Step 2, now we need to rewrite all of our independent equations and have them all solve for an individual x term, like so. Step 3, once we have rewritten all of our system of linear equations, it is often wise at this point to create a table to summarize all of your relevant information. This is how I would recommend setting up your table. However, as long as your table has all the important information on it, and you understand it, that is all that matters. Step 4. Now we are ready to solve for iteration 1. We use our latest guesses of x2 and x3 here to help us solve for x1 at iteration 1. Then we must solve for x2 and use our latest guesses for x1 and x3 to solve for it. Just note that this is where the major difference between the Jacobi iteration method and the Gauss-Seidel method are. In Jacobi method, we would not use the x values in the same iteration on one another. However, in the Gauss-Seidel method, we do, and this almost always leads to us finding a solution quicker, if there is one. Lastly, let's move on to solving x3 for iteration 1, and to do this, we use x1 and x2 that we found in the first iteration column here. Step 5. Now that all of the x values for iteration 1 have been found, we can move forward to iteration 2 and solve for x1 using the x2 and x3 values found in iteration 1. Step 6, and that's really it. You just keep completing iterations until you get close enough to your acceptable amount of error. If you were coding this, then you would just verify that the right side of all of your equations is within your error tolerance to the left side of your equations, when all your current iteration guesses of x are entered. If you're writing this out on a test, or even for a simple system of linear equations, you could just simply plug in all your x values to your equations by hand and see how close you are. In the next video, we're going to go through and solve a proper example using this Gauss-Seidel method by hand. And then in the following videos, we will implement this into Python and Microsoft Excel. Once these videos are uploaded, I will link them in the description below. So if you're at all still confused on how to use the Gauss-Seidel method, those few videos should clear it right up. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of the theory behind how we solve a system of linear equations using the Gauss-Seidel method. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and check out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.